What is going on, guys? Sterling with Handsome WP here. Today we're going to be taking a look at how to customize your WooCommerce checkout, and we're going to be customizing a few different elements. Number one is going to be our button color. We're going to make sure that our buttons look good across the board, and I'm going to show you how to update those, and then also how to add some custom styles to our inputs so our inputs can look a little bit nicer than the default inputs. So here we are in our checkout, and you can see that I don't have any borders on my my checkout. This is just the inherited style from my theme, so I don't have any borders on my checkout inputs, and then my button is just black, and then when I hover it goes, or it's like a dark gray, and then when I hover it goes black. So very simple. We're gonna wanna make this look a little bit better and at least have control over what color our buttons are, and then also a little more control over the look and feel of our inputs. And to do this, we need to add a little bit of custom CSS to our website. So there's a couple different ways to do it. We're gonna run over one of those first. Before we actually add the CSS to our website, I did want to mention that a lot of themes, and this is all kind of dependent on the theme that you're using, have color settings for WooCommerce built into the theme. Now, you would probably find those under appearance, and then if we go to customize, most themes integrate with the WordPress customizer. So if I scroll down, you can see here I have like homepage settings, but then here's a WooCommerce tab. If I click on the WooCommerce tab and I click on my checkout, you can see I do have some settings in my WooCommerce settings. I believe we're using storefront on this demo website. So if you're using storefront, you will not have color color settings, but here you can see a lot of the time they'll add in like default button colors and some other stuff like that, or sometimes it will be put in your overall color. So here's like your button background button color. You may pull from this initially. It doesn't look like it does because our WooCommerce button colors are not, they're not green, so I don't think it is pulling from that, but sometimes it will be pulled from somewhere in here. Now, to add our CSS, we can always add additional CSS in the additional CSS tab in the customizer, and we can just add our CSS to this section. The problem with that is it's going to load it site-wide. We don't really want to load this the CSS site-wide. We really only need it on a checkout page, and we need it on the cart page. If we have it loading on those two pages, we should be good. So a couple different methods to add your CSS that are going to be a little bit better is, number one, just add it to an HTML section. So if you just, this is for Gutenberg, but if we just did HTML, you can just add a custom HTML section, and then you can just copy and paste your CSS right in there. Now, just note you are going to need style tags if you do this, and then it can be a little bit finicky adding JavaScript or CSS or things into the custom HTML sections. Plus, you're not loading it in the header, which sometimes you want to load in the header or in the footer, just depending on your use case. But so I would not even suggest doing it this way. What I would probably do is install a plugin, and it's called Headers and Footer Scripts. And you'll notice, once you have that installed and activated, you'll notice on my page that I was editing, I have this little section below that's called Insert Script Ahead. So I can actually paste in my scripts in this little section, and that's gonna load in the head of my website. But the nice thing is it's only gonna load on this demo page or whatever page you add it to, so it's not gonna load site-wide. So it's a great way to add like tracking scripts and stuff like that to your website as well. But this would be a great way to do it. The way I'm going to actually do it is using advanced scripts. I love advanced scripts, and it has, you know, markdown and just looks nicer, and I just love using advanced scripts. So I just created a simple custom CSS. I'm loading it everywhere. I'm loading it in the head, and then I could set conditions to load it only on my checkout and my cart page if I wanted. I'm not going to worry about doing that right this second, but here is the CSS that we pasted in. Okay guys, so before we go and look at the front end and kind of compare when this style has been applied and when it's not, I just want to run through exactly what's happening and show you exactly what you need to update. You don't need to know how to use CSS in order to do this. You just have to kind of get the basic concepts, which is these are the selectors, and I'm going to explain it to you guys as well so you don't have to even figure it out yourselves. But here is my selectors for my buttons. This is my main color. So this first little section in between these first two brackets is my main button color. So that, if I wanted to be black, I would just put black here, or green, or red, or you can put in a hex code for your color if you want. Now, if you're using Firefox, as I am in this example, we can click on more tools and we can click on eyedropper, and it will actually give you a little eyedropper so you could color. Let's say we wanted our buttons to be this kind of like orangey orangey color. So now that I selected that, I would just paste and swap out that hex code, and now our buttons are going to turn into this orangey color, and we'll do the same thing for our input so it matches, because you want probably your input border and your button to match, or you could make your input like a light gray or something, or you can basically do whatever you want. But this is going to be our main button color right here. This is going to be our border radius, and think of border radius as like corner roundness. So the higher the number this is, so we have 6 pixels. If we make this 100 pixels, it would make it into like a hot dog. If we make it like 10 pixels, it'll be pretty rounded. If we make it like 2 pixels, it will be pretty sharp, barely rounded. So this is what's going to affect the roundiness of our corners, if that makes sense. And then if we scroll down a little bit more, now we're getting into our hover classes. So these are basically just going to, and all of these other ones are just going to be our hover classes. So what we want to update is our background. We would set it to black or whatever we want our hover color to be. So in this example, I'm just setting it to black, black, and then here again, black, black. And you can tell this is a hover because if you look at these selectors, they have this little colon and then hover on it. That means it's looking at the same button selectors we have up here, but it's adding this hover class to it. So it's saying once you hover on the button, then change the color to whatever you have here. And then same thing here. You see this is also a hover selector, and then we have this set to black. So now the last thing that I want to take a look at, and let's put a couple more spaces down here so we can come down and look at it, is our input styles. And that's what this bottom section is. This is our input styling. And I've kept it pretty simple. Basically what I'm doing is I'm just adding a border to our inputs that is solid, and it is the color that we have selected. So I'm gonna actually make it the same color as our button. So I'm just gonna swap out that color, or you could put black or green or red or whatever you want, and it would use your browser default. And then here is the thickness of the border. So this is 2 pixels. This border is going to be 2 pixels wide, and a pixel is pretty small. So you could do 1 pixel if you want it to be really thin. You probably wouldn't want to go more than like 3 pixels. And then here you can see is our border radius once again. We're matching the button with our border radius, but we could in theory make our border radius different if we wanted. You probably want to keep it the same though. So you can adjust those things here. Just mainly the color, the pixel amount, and then also your border radius pixel. So bigger the number, more curvy, lower the number, less curvy, if that makes sense. And then we'll save this guy. Let's go back one more time to our checkout and take a look. So this is what it looks like, just really plain and boring. But if we come to our advanced scripts and we save and activate, then we're gonna come back to our checkout and refresh. And now you're gonna see that my borders have been applied. So I would probably not do these colors. You can see this doesn't look good. And then I have a green highlight as well. So I have a border active class on this. But if we made it like a light gray or something, that would look great. And it would just make it a little easier for our end users to use. They would be able to see the inputs a little bit better. But you can see here is our reddish, orangish button. And then if I hover, it turns black. And this is also being applied. And then you can see our button has actually got some curve to it. It's not just perfectly square now. And it's the same amount of curve that's being applied to these inputs. And if we go to our cart, let's refresh our cart as well. So there it is without it, and here it is with it. So now you can see my buttons are looking really good. If I hover, they turn black, and they're all the same color, all the same border radius. So we're able to kind of take control and style our checkout page the way that we want. So that's pretty much all there is to it, guys. It's not too hard. If you wanted to get any more advanced than that, you're gonna need to dig into to a little more style. Now, if you have any suggestions for another video that covers this maybe more in depth, let me know. But we could just inspect. You can always right click and inspect and then see kind of what classes you have and what styles you have. And you can even update live a lot of the different things. You can see how my button colors are changing. So if you want to kind of dive a little bit more into the weeds, feel free to, and then you would just go back to that script and update the classes that you needed so that it would apply on the front end. We're not going to cover all that in this video, but what we are going to cover is how to do this exact same thing using Handsome Checkout. So let's head over to Handsome Checkout, and I'm going to deactivate the script real quick. Then we will head over to Handsome Checkout, and we'll look at all of our checkouts. And then we're gonna scroll down to the My Handsome Checkout, and we're gonna open the back end, but we're also gonna view it in a new tab. So here you can see it's looking very good. So I have a red hover on this template, but you can see here's my cart over here to the side. I'm able to add testimonials and trust seals and all kinds of stuff. It's a step checkout, so I have multiple steps where I can move back and forth between my steps, makes it a little more palatable. I was able to customize, and I actually have another video, guys, customizing checkout fields, and I do it through a function And then I also show you how to do it with Handsome Checkout. So if you would like to go and check that video out, I will have a link in the description leading to that video. But basically, just looks really nice out of the box. You know, we have our logo on there, and I'm zoomed in, so the logo's huge. If I zoom out, the logo would be more normal sized. But basically, you can see it looks really nice. And then if I wanted to adjust the colors for anything, let's say I want to make my button blue, let's just select a blue, we'll select another blue. You can select the same blue and it won't have any gradient, but I'm gonna do a gradient, so I'm gonna go a little bit darker on this. And then if we update and we come back to my Handsome Checkout and refresh, now my buttons are gonna be this nice blue gradient. So really you have a lot of control over the look and feel of your Handsome Checkout. You can just select the colors right here, as well as do all this other cool stuff. Add bullet points and testimonials and trust seals and logo arrangement and fields and all this good stuff. Plus we have all of these different templates. So I'm just gonna select a different template just for example sake. Let's just select we'll do the market web cart blue, and then we'll come back and we'll refresh. And you can see there's a completely different look and feel to the page. Let's do marketing pro. And I do have to change. You can see my header was dark and my logo's dark, so I'd have to update my header to be white there. But other than that, you can see how easy it is to switch between these different templates and how nice they look right out of the box. So you can kind of take whatever route you want. If you want to use the custom code route using CSS, feel free. We want to, you know, help everybody succeed no matter what they're trying to do. So I will have this script downloadable on our website. I will have a link to that blog post in the description below. Feel free to click that and go and grab this code and add it to your website. But if you are interested in any of our plugins or in Handsome Checkout, I will have links also to those plugins in the description below. So feel free to go and investigate those, and you could even test those out on our site if you want as well. So thank you guys so much for watching. Again, my name is Sterling. I hope this was helpful and you found this informative. I'm going to be making tons of videos like this. So if you use WordPress or WooCommerce or know somebody who does and you want to have some more awesome information and awesome scripts to use on your website stuff, make sure you subscribe and throw a like. It really helps us out. And once again, I appreciate you watching and I will see you in the next video.